So welcome to this, and this is really fun to see so many people wanting to hear about Scania's journey. So welcome. And if you don't challenge yourself to the max, you will never be great. So this is us challenging ourselves, standing here today speaking. And we think that you will learn, well, something from us. And we will, of course, learn a lot from you as well. So I hope to see you in Speaker's Corner afterwards, so we can share thoughts. So welcome to our future at Scania, where we are joining the forces of Agile coaches and HR to boost Agile transformation. And my name is Marie Kjellberg, and I work as an Agile coach at Scania IT.
My name is Malin and I also work as an Agile coach at Scania IT.
And my name is Anna-Karin, and I work in the central HR organization of Scania.
And just to put you in the context of what we work and our challenges, Scania is a world leading provider of trucks, buses and engines, and we have more than 52,000 employees in over 100 countries.
And in Södertälje we are around 16,000 employees and approximately 1,200 within IT.
Yeah, and then we have the global HR organization consisting of 500 people worldwide. And in the IT organization, we have an HR function with 20 people. And there, that is also including the Agile coaches, and they are currently 8 in numbers.
So, and the vision of Scania is that we drive the shift towards the sustainable transport system. And that, of course, is a real big challenge for us. Because with the global trends, urbanization, sustainability, and digitalization, we will set the new standard with technologies like connected, electrified, and autonomous. And this will of course drive the shift, will be a challenge to drive the shift. And it will of course transform the industry, the transport industry. And we will see a lot of things in this shift. And like the last technology leap we had, this is really a big one. But the last one we had was 100 years ago when the combustion engine was invented. And we know for sure that it will take a lot of more, or not 100 years, before the next shift will come. So it will move, of course, in a much quicker pace. So a big challenge. And this will, of course, also completely change the way we see in people and how they will work. And new business models will, of course, need to emerge as well. So we need to engage the people in a much better way. And we will need to wake up the happy sleepers. So, how did the journey start? We started with the Agile transformation, actually, a couple of years ago with Scania. Do you want to share the story, how it started, Malin?
The journey really started when we set up a team within Scania IT called Improvement Office with a focus on the Agile journey. It was a team of Agile coaches and some other people. And to start off with, we did a lot of trainings and coaching of the managers and the teams. And back then, it was quite a lot of focus on the methods like Scrum and Kanban. And after a while, we realized that the teams didn't really understand why they needed to change and why it would be good for them to actually be agile. So we realized we needed to change something. So we tried to focus more on the leadership and the mindsets, and we worked a lot on defining the new leadership for Scania IT. We had a lot of workshops with the management team, and they created this servant leadership manifesto, which explains what kind of behaviors they want to see in the organization and what kind of behaviors we want to move away from. And of course, it's a change for everyone, not just the managers. Everyone in the organization needs to change. Around this time, we also came across Pia Mia's book, Agile People, and we thought that we really need to involve HR as well on the Agile journey. They can actually enable a lot of the things that we need to be more agile. That's why we decided to really work closer to them, since we have a lot of things in common, like leadership, the passion for people and culture. And we could be a lot stronger working together, the Agile coaches and HR.
And how did you do it? Concrete example for how you did it?
Well, the first thing we did was that we moved the Agile coach team, the improvement office, into the HR organization so that we were part of the same organization. And then we also moved physical locations so that we sat all together, seeing each other daily, being able to collaborate even more closely with each other.
Yes. How did HR experience this change?
Yes, of course, it was a change for the HR organization as well. And first of all, I think we got to learn, of course, a lot more about Agile. What is it? What does it mean? And also could adapt quickly to some good ways of working, traditional coming from the Agile, with more quicker feedback loops and more reflections, taking that into our own ways of working in HR. Then, of course, supporting the organization, for example, with recruitment, is much easier if you understand what it is that we're trying to build, how we want to work, what is the vocabulary used in when talking to people that come from and want to work in an agile environment. So that was really, really helpful. And of course, with the servant leadership, that was also something very important for us in HR to understand. We are in many cases sitting in the leadership teams out in the organization. We can follow this on a daily basis and coach and encourage the leaders, but also the employees out in the organization to embark on this journey and to achieve what the management team had set up and what we wanted to achieve. So that was really something where we could see that we could also contribute to this journey a lot. And of course, there are some challenges as well, trying to start up something new in a part of the organization. And then at the same time, belonging to the big HR organization of Scania and trying to move into more agile ways of working, while maybe some of the central processes are not always so agile. So, yeah, that's of course a challenge that we are facing.
So how was it for the agile coaches? How were they experienced it?
Well, it was a bit of a challenge at first. We felt that HR was quite traditional, and we as Agile coaches had lots of ideas of how we wanted to change AR, so it was a bit of a clash. But we found quite soon that we could actually get closer to each other and understand each other really well. We also felt that HR was a bit more manager-centric, whereas we were closer to the teams and the individuals. But that was a good thing as well, because then we could have like both perspectives from each other. And we learned a lot about HR, how broad it is and the challenges they are facing in the organization. And by sharing experiences and what challenges we had, and by questioning each other, we could have better discussions and not just sort of talking to supporters of Agile, but actually thinking even deeper what we thought. So,
Yeah. And this cooperation between Agile coaches and HR also opened doors to other parts of HR, central HR, for example. How did that journey start?
Yes, it did. We were very happy at Central HR actually to be invited to the Agile people training that we did this spring. So we took this IC Agile certification together with Pia-Mia. Welcome to the room. Thank you for coming. And that was really, for me, who has been working in HR for quite many years now, it was an eye-opener. It was like, okay, under which stone exactly were we buried? I mean, where did all this controlling and all these things that we have been spending most of our time on, where did it come from? This is what actually matters. I read the book as well, and I was so sort of, it was really touching my heart and my stomach and the feeling that this is what really matters. So it was a well-needed wake-up call, I would say. So what we did during this training, we then had people participating from different parts of the organization, both from IT, from the Agile coaches, and from HR, from different departments as well. So we discussed a lot about how this Agile journey could take place within within Scania. You can maybe take the next slide there. This is an example of the results, what we did. So we did a lot of discussion around performance management, the engagement surveys, all different parts of HR, and try to understand how is it different in an agile world compared to the traditional world. And of course, it is a challenge in an organization as big as Scania, and we have also actually a quite decentralized HR function, which could be seen as good in many cases when you want to work and we're close to the business and all of that. But at the same time, we don't have a solid common ground to start from either. So some things are really a waste that could be made more efficient by doing them in the same way and collaborating more across the borders, whereas some things should, of course, be very local and very much adapted to the business that you are in, but not everything needs to be that. So that is sort of the challenge that we have, and what we also saw when we discussed this in the context of Scania, that we cannot go totally agile, maybe to the extent that you can do in a small startup or when you're starting up a new company. We need to adopt and we need to do this in a good way to combine both the efficiency of being and the economies of scale, or whatever you would call it, that you can have in a big organization, but with also being fast, agile, and adaptive.
Yeah. Servant leadership and this agile journey, what is the next step for you?
Yes, so what we continued doing after them from Central HR perspective, after we had taken this training, was that I took the concepts with me together with my colleagues, and we didn't talk so much about now we need to move into agile ways of working, but we actually did more of sneaking it in. And when we were going to go through some of the principles and some of the global processes that we have in HR, we put a very agile mindset on one end of the scale and a very traditional one on the other end of the scale, which then started a lot of discussions in the teams. And where we, of course, sometimes ended up closer to the traditional way of working and sometimes maybe closer to the agile. But it was a very healthy exercise, not just to get stuck in the old ways of working.
Do you have any concrete examples for the next step?
Yes, we do actually. Right now we're working specifically with the onboarding process and reviewing that one. And we have put together a cross-functional team together with HR and with IT to capture the whole onboarding experience. It's important to get your computer and to have things in place when you are going to start. But it's equally important, of course, to get a proper introduction, to meet the people you need, to get acquainted with our vision, the strategy, etc. All those things. But it's different departments in the organization, of course, that contributes to that journey. So we have a very much a focus on the user experience. We are building really a customer journey. We are going out and asking people that have recently been onboarded to Scania, what was their experience, how can we improve, and what is important to them. And then we will do some quick design thinking here and try to accomplish things in a quick way so we can improve, and we will do pilots and we will quickly get feedback so that we can continue that journey. And we also have a lean startup concept in Scania, and onboarding will be one of the things that we will look into there. We will, during 6 months, work in a concentrated team focusing on parts of the onboarding process.
Great. So what other initiatives are we working on?
At Scania IT, right now we are implementing OKRs across the organization as the way to for everyone to understand the strategies and how they contribute to them. So right now, all the teams are writing their team OKRs and individual OKRs. And of course, we at HR are doing our OKRs as well. So these are some of the OKRs that we are working on. And this work is under progress right now. So this is the first version.
Yes. So yes, this was 2 minutes. Good.
Then we have room maybe for some questions.
Yes, we have actually. Yes. Quite quick, yes.
Yeah. I just want to say I'm so impressed. This is the first time I see this in Sweden, that HR and adult coaches are joining forces. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.